Okay, so we have here the short axis view of the mitral valve taken in the 2D echo, and you can see that it is the diastole, the mitral valve in the short axis, and this is in the both will be taken in the diastole, not in the systole. So diastolic mitral valve area calculation is done, and when you can see that usually mitral valve opens like this, it has to open like this and this, and there are two commissures called anterolateral and posterior medial commissures, anteromedial and posterolateral commissures, and these two commissures have to be opening without any trouble. So it should be like bi-leaflet. But here it has become like a fish mouth appearance. That was, it is called as fish mouth appearance, and usually it happens because of the fusion of the commissures. So fish mouth appearance is seen in the mitral stenosis, and this is the planimetric measurement of the area of the mitral stenosis. In the diastole you measure the planimetric area, so just put some lines and you cover it, and it will show the mitral valve area. This is the measurement of the planimetry. So in short axis you will see for few things: complete opening of the mitral valve, it is not opening, then see for the commissures. If the commissures are closed, then look for the calcification and fibrosis and subvalvular apparatus in the short axis. If it is severely calcified, that means enhancement is huge, severely calcified and commissures are fused and commissural calcifications are huge, then most probably the patient will not get any benefit from the balloon valvuloplasty. Most probably the patient would have to go for mitral valve replacement. If the commissures are fused and not calcified, and there is no huge calcification on the mitral valve, there is no chronic mitral valve changes, then most probably the patient will get benefit from the mitral valve balloon valvuloplasty. You also, if the mitral valve stenosis is there but there is no commissural fusion, most probably the patient is having annular mitral stenosis or degenerative mitral stenosis, in that time also the patient will not be getting any help from the percutaneous mitral valvuloplasty.